Right on.
Oh, God. Thank you. Seriously. Oh. Scissor, shad, slab.
Welcome back to our YouTube channel. You know, I get a lot of texts from our videos here on YouTube with regard to the different techniques and presentations we use to catch crappie. And it can be sometimes confusing and stuff, but it doesn't have to be. But one of the most popular questions or topics is the jigs for spring. Okay, everyone loves spring fishing. Fish are ganged up. It's not too hard to find them or catch them. But based on water temperature, clarity, there's a few guidelines we use to choose the jigs we have. So this YouTube video is called Top 5 Choices of Jigs for Spring Crappie. They're not necessarily all about color, although sometimes there's a few colors I can explain that I have to have in my boat or in my pocket. Or regards whoever I'm fishing with, these jigs will be with me. Some are about vibration, a little bit more is about size, and some is about the bulkiness of provoking strikes. So without further ado, here's your top five from 1 to 5, no particular order, but make sure you've got these jigs in your boat and you'll catch more and bigger crappie this spring.
Well, here we go with Joshy. Guess where we're going? Crappie fishing. There's Joshy. Man, it's something about spring when it just comes. So we're gonna show you some different techniques we're gonna have today. We don't have 15 rods rigged up. You know, we might have 15 rods, but only 2 or 3 presentations.
Number one consideration for me is chartreuse. Something about that color in our logo and a crappie's mindset is seeing chartreuse. I don't know if it makes them mad, glad, anything, but chartreuse is my number one consideration. You know, it gives me confidence, and trust me when I tell you, any kind of fishing, it's about having confidence in your abilities, tactics, techniques, where you are, what you're doing. But if you have a certain focus on certain colors that help you catch more fish, who cares what anybody else even says?
Slab magnet right here. Blake's Glow, really bright chartreuse, especially in that off-color water with the chartreuse jig head, it's perfect. Or Zoe's Glow, it's got a chartreuse back, but the belly is more like an iridescent, almost like a luminant, you know, a little bit of flake, clear, but it still has a little bit of off-color, so maybe like a belly, okay? There's my two choices, as well as probably chartreuse white for the slab magnet. When it comes to crappie magnet, right there, smaller profile, chartreuse and white. You see, I got the bulk pack because I go through these things. I use these a lot. Oh my goodness, look at that. In that weed. Oh boy. What do you think of that? What do you think of that? Are you convinced now? Float's the deal? Are you convinced? Look at that, man. That's slab magnets. Look at that. Tell me that's not a gorgeous fish. Gorgeous crappie.
Now again, it's all about the color preference that gives you confidence. In this next little segment, it's about fishing for crappies with a float. And I toned down a little bit with regard to the size. Sometimes size is a big consideration. If they're not really aggressive, they're feeding on tiny perch or whatever it is, minnows, etc. You know what? Don't try to make it too complicated. Just have different sizes in your bait or your box, okay? So I got some that are bigger shad bait profiles, some that are smaller with kick and tails, totally whatever you want to use, but have some ready for when you tie on that cork, throw it out and watch it go down.
I call it the orangesicle or creamsicle with a little bit of lemon meringue at the back. It does not sound good. Do you want to eat it? Well, the crappie do, but for me, that anything with orange and chartreuse, don't worry about water clarity. We're fishing for crappies, remember? You want their attention so they see it and eat it. Another one, obviously, is bright bubblegum pink with chartreuse. See the common theme? Chartreuse, crappie, pink. You got it. And of course, salt and pepper, so you have that natural kind of tone, but again, chartreuse. Those are my three colors on days when I need to catch them in spring and they're not biting real hot and heavy, but I still want to catch crappies. I go with the little crappie magnet and the bright colors, sometimes the salt and pepper, sometimes pink, sometimes orange, but they all have chartreuse. Crappie, like right there. Yep, crappie. good crappie too. Look at it. Oh God, dude. Look at this. The magnet is drawn. Oh God, moly, hey. Beautiful, man, beautiful size fish. Sometimes when you're not catching a lot, you're catching good ones. It's, for me, it's like bass fishing. I don't need to catch a lot. I'd rather catch big ones.
See these right there? Bright lime chartreuse. Great for St. Paddy's Day, huh? But boy, oh boy, fishing with my buddy Joshy, these baits produced some of the biggest crappie on one of our trips in early spring. The fish were nowhere to be shallow. We tried them with floats and stuff. We just decided that we're going to have to go out to the main lake basin, okay? Flat bottom like a bowl, but just fine schools of fish. We found the fish. He kicked my butt because he picked up his favorite little green bait with a little chartreuse tail and just pounded some big 2+ pound black crappie vertical jigging the main lake basins.
We're gonna start off out here. We're gonna look for them in the deep part of the basin. We're gonna use these jigs I make by my Northern Tackle Supply Company. We're gonna use about a 5/32nd, maybe a tad smaller, but we're gonna use a 5/32nd to keep a straight vertical. And I don't really like to give up my favorite colors, but it's that chartreuse green, and it's gonna be there all day long.
There's one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Netter, huh?
Not a bad one.
Oh. King Kong. Wow, dude. First boxer. Oh my goodness, dude. Yeah, that's
nice. And look, where's that crappy magnet? Wow. It's gone.
Wow. Give him a close up of that. Get him zoom in on it, Josh. Wow, dude. That's a big crappy.
A nice, gorgeous fish here.
Yeah, man. I like the double green too, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Josh said he loves the green. So the Kelly green, I call it, with the chartreuse, you can't beat it. And see the common theme? Green, 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 green. This one has almost like a green with a refrigerator white. Solid chartreuse, black chartreuse with a little bit of silver flake. And the therapist, these colors right here, we're not going to divulge too much from variety. And whatever seems to be catching fish, and so far Josh has proven that the bright Kelly green with the chartreuse is kicking butt of all the other colors. But have variety, be prepared, because you never know what the crap you want on the lakes you fish. Look at the ones down there. My goodness.
Ooh. There we go.
Good one?
Yeah.
Oh, Josh is. Oh, atta boy, Josh.
Beautiful.
He knows the King Kong crappie on his lake. Oh my goodness, you should see this screen, dude.
A nice, beautiful.
Beautiful fish, Josh.
Slamming these nice. Boom. Once again, another female. Look at the size of the belly on these guys.
Yeah.
Wow.
We'll take pictures and let them go.
Little egg wagons right here.
Do you believe it? Do you believe it?
The whole world now knows, Joshy, your favorite little lime and chartreuse. But you know what? Kevin Van Dam said it perfect. All those classics and hundreds of boats knowing where a fish is. They still got to go out. They still got to tie in the right bait. They still got to present the bait the same way and catch the fish. So if people know where you fish, so be it. That's just the beauty of fishing. Everybody's entitled to it. It's a free world. So pick the baits that work for you. Obviously, the chartreuse work for that boy.
There we go.
Good?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Hear that? When he says that?
That's a big crap.
Oh my good. Are you kidding? Dude. I'm going to fall out of the boat. I'm just. Dude, that's not a big crap. That
meat
is a
wagons,
giant.
Boys.
Dude.
Look at these suckers.
That's Mississippi style right there, eh?
Oh, there you go.
That man. Is. We're not in Mississippi either. This is Northern Ontario, Parry Sound. Dude, that is a monster. Monster.
Just gorgeous fish.
You just made my spring right there, Josh.
Ah, no problem, man.
You weren't kidding.
No, I don't lie.
Dude, that is sick, sick. I've seen some big ones in the States. That's comparable. Hold them sideways for him, Josh.
Ah, big old sucker. size of the yappers.
Wasn't that cool? And it's very important, man. Catch and release. Some fisheries are very, very delicate, okay? So you're fishing for pre-spawn fish. Their bellies are really packed full of little fingerlings and babies. So the future of fishing is even better. So consider catch and release of those big females. Yeah, take those pictures. Put them on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Instagram. You name it, man. If there's a platform, let the world know that they should get into crappie fishing. But please respect the fishery and let those big girls go to live another day. This part is called baits with balls. You heard it right, okay? There's no other ulterior motives to this segment, but these little baits with balls I have to have in my boat. Something about the little triggering effect of the fat little shad bait, okay? And it's a striking bait called the little shad pole. Everybody makes it. Bobby Garland, everybody has it. Okay, there's no more secrets in the crappie fishing industry, you know, or patents and stuff. They say there is, but there's really not. Everybody just copycats everybody else's baits. Why? Because they catch crappie. I like having them because those little balls, you don't have to do a lot.
If you love bass fishing or walleye fishing, you live for that tick. And that's either throwing that big flipping jig by a dock or ripping a little grub or a little hair jig on a weed line for walleye. That bait's falling and all you feel is that magical tick. There's only one thing it can be, fish. And in this case, they're just honkered right inside this tree. And that little shad pole inside there, as soon as it goes down, I lift. I'm not even shaking a lot because that little tail, as you can see, that little ball moves enough. Sometimes the least amount of action is the best. Putting it down a little bit, hold it. Or all of a sudden there's a weight sensation and crappie on. Ooh, nice crappie. Nice crappie. Look at that thing fight. Look at that. Right in the nose too. Whoa, that's a good one right there, boy. That's a good one right there. That's another eater. That's what I call an eater right there. Look at that. Big, beautiful slab, boy. Oh yeah, look at that. Gorgeous crappie right there. Nice thick backs on them. Look at that. Tell me you wouldn't want 10 of those, 12 of those, make for a good meal.
When I pick up the 10, 11, or 12 foot jig pole, look out, get out of my way, because I'm about to just do some major destruction in fallen trees, docks, brush, deep brush piles. I don't care what it is. If I tie it a little bit with balls, it's crush time.
Everyone has their favorite colors, but I like anything like the electric chicken with pink chartreuse. And this water is fairly clear. I could actually see some of those bites in the trees, but it doesn't matter. When you're right on those fish and they're congregated and they're really holding to a little spot like that, something that attracts their attention will eat it. So the pink chartreuse, you know, black with a little bit of purple. Then I have that, like that purple haze. It has the purple with the chartreuse. Awesome little bait. Chartreuse white, I think it's called refrigerator white. And you got the natural tones like the blue and silvers, natural salt and pepper. And of course, like the blue glitter, almost looks like a real minnow, killer. Buy the ones you're comfortable with. So I would suggest you buy a lot. Oh boy, that one is big. And look at where he's caught around. He is around the tree. Oh Lordy, let him swim a bit. Oh no, look at him. That is a big, big crappie. Look at him, caught up around the tree, over the tree, get around the tree. Oh, is he coming in the boat? Look where he got it too. Tell me he didn't want that thing. When that little shad pole's in the right spot, and that is inside that tree, they just bulldoze their way to find it and eat it. Again, another fine eater. You know what? Just not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the big, fat slabs. But that's a good eater right there.
See that? You know what that is? That's the one single color that I will never fish for crappie without. I don't care where I am. That little gold flappy tail.
the Gold Fleck body, and I don't care what manufacturer makes it, it's all irrelevant. It's that little sparkle. And in the real dirty water, on a couple segments coming up, think about that. It's the vibration it's giving off, the profile of the bait. And in real dirty water, color is not a real big consideration as long as you give a silhouette, okay? So a little bit bigger body, the chartreuse shows up in virtually anything, man. The red clay of Mississippi and Alabama, up here in Ontario. If we have floods and stuff like that, high water rains, the water can get really murky and you think, too dirty for crappie. If you think that, please move out of the way so I can pull in with my boat and have some fun. So single poling with this here is as deadly as it gets. This is money right here.
Okay, this is a deal today, right there. My crappie magnet, the slab magnet. And it's a thicker profile like a shad bait, okay? Flat top, little flat tail. And look at that, you barely gotta move your arm. Shows you in the water that I barely shake my wrist. Get that tail just to kick. When I'm fishing with this 12 footer, and I got, well, I'd say almost 12, 13 feet coming down, that gives me 25 plus feet of range. I put the power poles down, find a tree, find a dock, find the fish first with the Garmin, and then just dissect and crush. I'm holding that thing down about 4 inches below the surface, and it's so bright, obnoxious color. Like, look at this thing right here. So bright and obnoxious. Bright chartreuse head, chartreuse little tail, gold body. Like, it's something that, man, you want the brightest, most obnoxious things on a day like this when you're fishing water that's from floods, rains, and it's murky. I'm gonna call it just dirty. You can't even see the fish. You just gotta have faith that you're putting in the right spots. Look at that, hey? That is what I'm fishing for, dudes. Ready? Here comes the big swing. He's big and he's bad. He's big and he's bad. And I thought, I don't know if you're the same one I just seen, boy. Whoa, look at that. Whoa, he's got major attitude, but just a beautiful fish, man. I'm gonna put you in. You are gonna taste so good. First crappie feed of the year. First crappie feed of the year. Catching big, beautiful slabs, boy. Golden black. Look at it. Golden black. Hey? Oh, yeah. You know what? For me, it's all about hunting them down, boys. Let's put them in there. Look at that. I only got 6 crappie. 6 crappie. How many crappie do you need for a meal? You know? Because once you find them, it's incredible. Put the poles down, anchor down, and just wait. Single pole and going around. Getting their attention, bringing it up, shake it, round, swim it, stop it. And it's just like they come out of the tree, they look, roll on it. But they don't come flying at it. They just slowly come up. You don't see them in that dirty water. You just see that last flash, or all you see is this little bait disappear.
Hair jigs. Why is something so small so deadly for crappie? Is it the little profile that looks so unintimidating? Is it the little hairs, you know, just something that they can just look at and just inhale, like a little sample, like a little M&M, a bowl of them. If they put them on the counter, they're going to be gone in an hour because you can't walk by it and not pick up a little M&M. Okay, no sponsor pun or endorsements there because we're not, but I love to eat them. Don't you? So the little hair jigs, but there's so many different ways to fish them. Under floats, swimming them, but again, the single pole. I am a hunter, a bass fisherman first and foremost. Look at this one. Oh, netter, dude.
Ow. Look at that. Look at that beauty. Ooh-wee. Look at the colors. Wow. Look.
Hey. How's that? For a crappie single poling, dudes, that is incredible, man. Incredible. Where are those pliers? Crappie magnet has made these perfection right there. That's perfection. Little hair jig. It's called a Popeye. You heard it before, you seen it before. I mean, phenomenal. Look at the size of these crappies, dude. Look at that. Beautiful,
black slab, Northern Ontario. That's what you single pull for. Love the float, love the crank, but you can't beat single pull Big Crappie.
And when I can stock down Big Crappie, black or white, with a jig pull, it's done. It's over. If I find them and I take my time on different bodies of water or favorable ones, like I do with my buddy Joshy, and we pick up a little hair jig, one of our favorites, whatever color he's picked, I pick, but it's the presentation.
There he goes. Netter?
Yeah, I think maybe. Maybe not.
You can crane him?
Yep. I got him. Sorry, guys. This is all new to this guy.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Look at that nice one. Oh, all right.
I mean, that's not fun. Look at the size of that, too. Look at that. Gorgeous crappie.
Beauty.
See how long it takes sometimes?
Oh. See you later, buddy. Woo.
So tiny, yet so deadly. So tiny, yet so deadly. You gotta have some hair jigs in your boat. It's number 4 on my list of 5 different jigs that I have to have in my boat for spring. If you haven't got hair jigs in there, you're literally missing the boat. Pick up some at your favorite shop. There's all different kind. A company called Slab Syndicate. I've really been hooked onto those guys. Ken's Jigs. There's all different kinds, you know, Popeye Jigs. Pick what's favorable for you based on your budget. But man, pick up some hair jigs. You'll never go wrong.
There you go.
Oh, that's another good one, Josh.
Yep, I'm right here this time.
Oh, wow.
Thanks, man.
No problem.
That was ghost fishing again, dude, just in front of the boat.
That's the way to do it, eh?
Ghost fishing. You know what I do? I pitch it out and I hold it with my other hand, Josh, so the jig is going really slow. Because I've watched these fish, they don't really want to chase, but if you go slow and stop it,
they bang. Want it.
I did it exactly there, and it's as soon as I stop the jig, tick. So I know you followed it out decent, but we got a few more like that for pictures, don't we, Josh, eh?
Oh, yes, we do.
All right.
A few more to come.
Well, for fun. Go on, boy. Wow. I tell you, man, this is just incredible. Catch them this way. One-on-one.
This is too much fun.
Crappy. Ooh. You know what's cool, too? Sometimes we're pitching up right against the bank, getting those males and stuff that are like, you know, 10, 11, 12-inch fish. Fun fish. But when you swim and stop, I call it swim and stop with the Popeye. I pitch it out and I control it with the left hand and just bring it down. When it's almost in line with the tip of the rod and it's right below the rod tip, I stop it and hold it. If there's any fish in that area, boom! And 2 or 3 times we did that, Josh did it as well. Swim it so they follow it, and as soon as it stops and you hold it, pow! They eat it.
There's one. Look, right here.
Good one? Oh, yeah. Oh, nice lifter. Nice one. That's how you do it. Pendle them out.
All right.
That's where you do it.
There we go. Hello, crap daddies. All right. That's fine, man. See you later, sweetie. Sweet.
Isn't it amazing when they actually
just gulp it and then you see that mouth just.
Yep. And last but not least, baits with bulk. Everybody likes the bulk, right? Well, this little thing right here, again, it's got balls on the back, big shad bait body, okay? I think it's called the Scissor Shad by Strike King. And I mean, these little things have accounted for some incredible catches for us here.
The crappie, off bottom and on bottom. 4.9 feet of water, fishing at 2:30 in the afternoon. And look at, because we're at the power poles down, so we're not moving. So you say, how come the bottom is changing and stuff? Those are the crappie on the bottom. Schools is going through on top of that weed, okay? Once in a while, you see them also come right up all through here. So we're just making casts in front of the boat, around the boat, and just once in a while. See how it keeps changing? Those are fish moving through this little ball neck area from the back bays and the bays where they want to spawn. And we're cutting them off at the pass, you know, like one of those cheesy spaghetti westerns. And then we're just catching them with the little scissor shads with the big thick body, sharp hook, little darter head, and then little balls going up along like that, catching those big fat slabs right there. Oh, dude, I saw him. I saw him.
Dude,
oh,
good. That's a tank.
Oh my God.
That's all I keep saying with these scissors. It's a tank.
Look at, no, really. This is sick. Dude.
I, buddy.
Come on.
Oh, come on. Sebastian,
get him, buddy. Get him, buddy.
Oh. What? That's not normal. Oh, dude. Right on.
Oh, God. Thank you. Seriously. Oh. Scissor, shad, slab.
Let me
look. No.
Hey. That is amazing.
Oh my God, look at that. When a hook goes in, they stay in, hey?
Wow.
How's that? Hey?
That is a massive fish, buddy.
Hey? Wow. Fish like this could drive a man to drink.
Yeah.
You know? Look at that.
Okay, I'm casting
right away.
Big,
beautiful crappie, boy. Wow. That one's pushing 2 pounds plus, you know that, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Look at the mouth on him. And you say it's scissor shads, huh? You say, how about springtime? How about going with micro tubes and stuff? Well, you know what? We do it. We have to do it. But when me and this guy here want to catch big crappies, big jerkbait, crankbait, sometimes even topwater, extreme crappie angler, you're going to see everything, including the big, thick scissor shads catch big fish like that when the water's 50 degrees. Well, let's regroup and hopefully we catch a few more like that, because I tell you, these kind of memories will last a lifetime.
These little baits, you can single pole them, you can fish them under a float, but we've had some memorable times fishing with my buddy Sea Bass on different bodies of water where the fish are just congregating back and forth, getting ready to do their business under floats in the middle of summer, in fall. But something about these baits in spring, when those bigger fish are on the prowl, you can't beat it.
Wow. Big, look how big that bait looks. Like something you should use for like walleyes or bass.
Well, that's the whole thing. But yeah. You see the results, right?
Yeah. Oh,
dude.
Lord. Oh my goodness.
I'm getting the net, buddy.
Oh my goodness. Look at that scissor shad, dude.
That was the one that just hit mine, dude.
Wow.
That is a pig. Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
Scissor shad madness.
Look at the size of that fish.
Look at that, hey? You say to yourself, crappie. Cold water crappie with a scissor shad. Look at it. But I'm going to show you how it gets sliced in the mouth, okay? Look at this right here, see? This is where I hooked the fish while fighting them. See how he tears? That's where you lose them when you drop the rod tip. Don't drop the rod when you're fighting them. Keep the tension and just lift them up. And that's how you catch them, right there. Big, fat, beautiful slabs with the scissor shads.
Well, there you got it. The top 5 jigs you gotta have in your boat for crappie in spring. Some are based on color, some are based on size, vibration, style, plastic, or hair. There's just 5 options for you to think about. I hope you catch some big fish this year, because you watch our YouTube channel, you adapt, you improvise, you overcome, just like the Marines of crappie fishing. You can do it. We did it. You'll always do it if you just keep your mind open, pick different baits, different styles of fishing, but man, have fun. Go out and catch crappies. Hope you subscribe to our YouTube channel. The button's right there. Please post your comments at the bottom right here, and we'll answer them from yours truly. We appreciate you watching. We'll see you next time, but fish safe so you can fish tomorrow.